Hello students, welcome to Avipedia. Today we are going to discuss how inclusive growth helps economic development. It's a very important topic and it's very helpful for UPSC. And we are just going to discuss the concept here and the difference between economic growth and development and various dimensions of inclusive growth. If you like this video, please share it, subscribe to Avipedia and learn. Now let me start. What is inclusive growth? Inclusive growth includes sharing of the fruits of socio-economic development with all sections of the society. All right. Now, poverty alleviation, inclusive growth, and sustainable development, they are intimately linked. India has been working towards inclusive growth since independence. In 1947, when we got independence, India was declared a mixed economy. And the state, since it was a welfare state, so the approach of the state, approach of the government was to focus on growth and development of our country. So basically, the policy focus of all the successive governments that we had so far was on inclusive growth. And inclusive growth means whatever benefits the economy is getting, it should be shared by all sections of the society. It should not be pocketed only by the rich and the influential, as it happens, because it creates a big gap between the rich and the poor. So, since all whatever five-year plans we had, so the focus was on inclusive growth. 11th five-year plan mentioned inclusive growth in its policy statement, and the policy focus of the 12th five-year plan was faster, sustainable, and more inclusive growth. Now what we have seen, despite higher rate of growth post-liberalization, the growth was not equitable. We are so-called civilized society. And what was being experienced was that the benefits of economic growth was not reaching the poorest segment of the society. The benefits were basically taken away by the rich and the influential people. So, what should be done? It never reached for whom it was meant. There were many yojanas, there were many policies, but it never reached the poorest segment of the society. And so, now, let me just differentiate here, because growth and economic growth and economic development. Economic growth was taking place in India, but economic development was not, because economic growth is a quantitative term. Increasing per capita income, increasing GDP, that is what is economic growth all about, quantitative terms. And economic development is much more than that. It's not only quantitative, but also qualitative. And there was one economist, a very famous one, who was also awarded a Nobel Prize, Simon Kuznets. He wrote a book, and Modern Economic Growth, that is the name of the book. And in that book, you know, he took some of the countries of old European heritage, that is England, Germany, France, and some of the countries of new European heritage, that was Canada, America, Australia, and only Asian country that was included in his study was Japan. And he tried to follow that why these countries became developed countries during 1750 to 1950, and why others are not able to become developed countries. So what we found out from his study, it was a very exhaustive study, because it was quite difficult to collect data from so many countries. But what we found out, and what was his result, was that they focused on qualitative aspect of economy. When you focus on qualitative aspect along with quantitative aspect, that is what is economic development in the real sense. So what was happening after independence, that economic growth was taking place, but there was no qualitative improvement in the economy. Qualitative growth was not taking place. So it never led to economic development. But now, inclusive growth, when we speak about inclusive growth, it focuses more on quantity rather than quantity. And now the focus we are focusing on quality of inclusion rather than quantity of inclusion. Now, according to Oxfam report, and the title of the report was Reward Work, Not Wealth, it was highlighted that richest 1% of India, they cornered 73% of the wealth that was generated last year, and 67 crore of Indians, comprising of the poorest half, they saw their wealth grow only by 1%. All right, so we have to now shift our focus from economic growth to economic development. And inclusive growth, which is an instrument for equitable distribution of benefits to the rich and poor, that becomes the policy instrument. So inclusive growth means that we share the growth, the benefits of growth, the fruits of growth, with every section of the society, especially the poorest segment of the society. So whatever policies we have, like you must have heard about Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, MNREGA, Digital India, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So through this, the government is focusing more on inclusive growth. So inclusive growth is very important if we want that the benefits of economic growth should reach the poorest segment of the society. Now, let me tell you, there are five dimensions of inclusive growth. You can see it here. The first one is social dimension. Second is economic. Third one is political dimension. Fourth is environmental. And fifth one, who are the stakeholders? So there are five dimensions of inclusive growth. That means we have to include them when we talk about inclusive growth, when we talk about qualitative growth, that is development. All right. Now, first dimension, let me discuss the first dimension, that is social dimension. That includes affordable education. Education should be affordable for the poorest segment of the society. It speaks about quality healthcare. Healthcare should not only be given to the rich persons. That's in bad taste. Are we living in a civilized society? If we are, then I think the healthcare, that quality healthcare, again I'm talking about quality, not quantity, it should reach the poorest to have access to healthcare. Then socially equal treatment. We have to remove this distance between the rich and the poor based on casteism, based on many other aspects. All right, we need to have socially equal treatment of everybody in the society. We are all equal. We are all born equal. So we should be equal. Treatment should be equal. Benefits should reach everybody equally. Then we speak about gender parity. There should not be difference between male and female. We need to have gender parity. We have to educate our female as well as males equally. There should not be any difference. That is part of our social dimension of inclusive growth. And there should be regional parity. We know that we have regional imbalance. Some of the regions are well developed and some of the regions are highly underdeveloped. So we need to have regional parity also. So these are all different aspects of social dimension of inclusive growth. Now I move on to the second one, that is economic dimension. Now under economic dimension, we need to have financial literacy and inclusion. Financial literacy is very important. Now when we talk about Jan Trinity, you must have heard about Jan Trinity, that is Jan Dhan Aadhaar Yojana, Jan Dhan, then again Aadhaar card, and M is mobile. J is Jan Dhan, A is Aadhaar card, and M is mobile. So now when we talk about Jan Trinity, so we are trying that people should be literate from the financial point of view. They should know how to operate their bank accounts. They should know how to operate their mobile. So financial literacy and inclusion is also part of economic inclusion. Then we have got agricultural development. If agricultural sector will develop, all the sectors have to develop, but we have to focus more on agricultural development. Then only there will be economic inclusion of the people. The people who are in the agricultural sector, the poor, the landless, they will also be included in the benefits. All right, whatever benefits, whatever in growth that the country is experiencing, it should go to the poorest segment of the society. So in agricultural sector, there is a lot of backwardness. So we have to include the people who are in agricultural sector by agricultural development. So that is also part of economic inclusion. Then there should be quality employment. We should not have disguised unemployment, which is very prevalent in the rural sector. We should have quality employment. Those who are qualified, they should get employment according to their qualifications. And then there should be connectivity and communication so that people have access to all the new types of communication. They are connected to the national mainstream. They are connected with whatever the policies the government is pursuing. If they are the beneficiaries, it's their right to know. And there should be resilience to external shocks. So these are all, they all come under the economic dimension of inclusive growth. Then we have third one, that is political dimension of inclusive growth. And political dimension of inclusive growth is also equally important. People should be politically connected. They should be aware. So there should be long-term perspective and planning. There should be transparent and efficient governance so that people are able to get their benefits. All right, the beneficiary, there should be transparency. So there will be naturally, corruption will be less. People will be able to get the benefits of socio-economic development. There should be safe borders. And there should be beyond discrimination, means people should not be discriminated against each other on the basis of caste, on the basis of language, on the basis of creed, on the basis of religion. And there should be zero corruption. Then only we can say that inclusive growth is taking place from the... So this is inclusive growth is taking place and it is helping the economic development of our country. And the fourth dimension, as you can see it in the diagram, you can see it on the board, that is environmental, and that is the fourth dimension. And how we are going to include the people so that they are able to reap the benefits. Now, we can do it by reduction of wastage, sustainable development, then protection of flora and fauna of our country. And we all know that government is the guardian of future generation. So by protecting the environment, it is not helping the present generation, it is also helping the future generations, because the government is the guardian. So government has to look after the interest of the future generations as well. So this is very important. And the fifth dimension, as you can see it here, who are the stakeholders? Who are the stakeholders? Number one, the government. When I talk about inclusive growth, who is going to provide inclusive growth? Naturally, the government. So first stakeholder would be the government, then NGOs, non-government organizations, then private sector, civil society, we, the people of India, and media. Media can also play a very important role in making aware about the inclusive growth, in making aware about the benefits, the policies that is meant for the poorest segment of the society, and also making us aware whether it's reaching them or not. This is very important, because we are now focusing on quality of inclusion rather than quantity of inclusion. All right? So qualitative aspect becomes more important, and that is what is going to take us to greater heights, and that is what India is going to make a developed country. And this is all about inclusive growth, and quality of inclusion should be focused rather than quantity of inclusion. We should not focus how many people have benefited, but we have to focus that whether it has reached the poorest segment, the deserving people for whom these policies are made, because there used to be misappropriation of funds, there used to be corrupt practices. So by inclusive growth, at least there will be transparency. Everybody will be included in the process of economic growth. Everybody will be equally, there will be the stakeholders of economic development. Everybody will participate in developing our country. And so there can be better implementation of the government policies if we focus on inclusive growth. Thank you, students. I hope you have understood what is inclusive growth, what are the dimensions of inclusive growth, and what is the difference between economic growth and economic development. So now it's time that we have to focus more on economic development rather than economic growth, because economic development includes quantitative growth as well as qualitative growth. Now it's time that we focus on the qualitative aspect of the economy. We try to see that each and every section of the society is benefited, everybody is enjoying the fruits of economic growth, everybody is participating in the process of economic growth. That is what is important. If you have liked the video and if you have understood the concept of inclusive growth, please subscribe Avipedia and share. Thank you very much.